seems like kind of a weird game that you guys dominated in shots and possession and looking at lane. What's kind of your read on how it ended and why it didn't end that way?
Man, once you go to the shootout, it's, you know, you obviously need a, I don't know if he's on or not, but you need a bounce or two, and we obviously didn't score any goals, so that doesn't help. But, you know, we didn't have the greatest start to the game, and first period was weird. It was, they got four straight power plays, and then we got four straight power plays or whatever that was. Got better as the game went on, and you know, I thought in the third, we actually played a really good third period and kept them, for the most part, to the outside. We got the odd scoring chance here and there, but, yeah, shitty way that they tie it up on. It's just kind of 30 seconds left. We got to figure that one out, but, yeah.
Does it kind of sour this run that you guys cannot?
Yeah, I mean, you want to keep it going, no doubt, and especially going into the All-Star break, but, whenever it was going to end, it was going to suck. Losing sucks no matter who it's against, or home or away or whatever. But streak in itself, I guess that's something that's cool once it's all said and done and you look back at the history books or whatever. But we just want to keep winning and keep putting ourselves in a good spot down the road here.
Did you feel like you guys did enough to get a win tonight?
Some parts of the game, yeah. I think, like Landy said, you know, first period was kind of weird. But I think we were, like, last two periods, we didn't give up a lot until they tie it up. So it's kind of, you know, it shouldn't happen, especially at home, the way we've been defending Leeds here. But it is what it is.
How, I guess, just like, what boots will the off that they can do
with the freshman out there? That'll be nice. Played a lot of hockey. I don't know how many games we'll have this month, but it's been a lot. We get for everybody to recharge and recover, and whether it's bumps and bruises or just mentally, it'll be good for get away for a few days and just recharge. It'll benefit everybody.
What have you guys learned about your team as you've been doing things first half of the year? What do you know about this team?
Well, we know we're a good team. We're capable of a lot of things, and we've been finding ways to win. I think there's still some things we know we can be better at, and especially now down the stretch, it's gonna be tougher schedule for us with some tough games. So obviously you want to build up your season the way so you finish well because the playoffs. So it's still a lot of work to do for us for sure.
Yeah, I think Mikko said it well. You know, we're finding ways to win even though we haven't played our best. I think that's the strength of a good team . Just like he mentioned, we got some areas that we have to get better at and some things we got to clean up. But I think our penalty kill has done a great job over the last couple of weeks here of getting better. Our power play has been up until tonight. Obviously, we didn't score well tonight, but I think we're fifth going into tonight. So special teams are going to be important down the stretch, and especially going away on some road trips. That's going to be important, but. Obviously, we're happy with where we're at this point in the season, but there's a lot of hockey left and a lot of things to do.
I think you guys might have been against Boston, but the last few games you guys two tried on three, but yeah, sort of what's kind of gone on?
You want to talk about those, or you want to talk about the four straight that we scored on the quarter?
I'm talking about either, whatever you want, Gabe.
No, I mean, it's a valid question. Listen, 5-on-3, you should score on it. One of those things where we have some plays drawn up and sometimes you, when you're out there, there's three guys on the outside and normally they're best defenders. They do a good job with sticks and positioning to take those plays away. But as a five-man unit, we got to find a way to generate more dangerous shots probably. And obviously we're missing Nate, but at the same time, we got a pretty good unit still. So. We got to look at the tape and see what was wrong with this one tonight.
A couple last ones, please.
In the shootout, the way Group kind of approached the shooter, they're a little unorthodox coming off that hard post. Did that throw you guys off at all, or
like when before we even touch the puck.
Shootout, he's kind of squared up from, I guess, off that far post to the middle of the net, right? So.
I didn't see anything like different than other goalies do. So I don't know, just our bad that we couldn't score there.
Yeah, you're either live or move. Like, you gotta look at the back.
I mean, if that's 5-on-5, it's probably a penalty, but 3-on-3 overtime. I mean, you look at the 2 minutes before, I can't remember who it was driving down the play on the right side by the penalty box, and their guy just blatantly just skates in front of Nas. It's 2-on-1, the length of the ice, and he just takes Nas out of the play. That's not a penalty, then Val shouldn't be a penalty, in my opinion. But
yeah.
Killed it off, and we did a great job of killing that.
Last one here, kids.
How easy would it be for you guys to say, you know, we just rattled off 18 straight at home, 10 straight overall, we still get a point, we're getting a break, nice job everyone. You guys definitely seem frustrated by this. Is that, you have to do with the culture you guys have built, the standard you guys have set for yourselves?
Yeah, I think so. You know, once you start winning, it's, I don't do a lot of drugs, but I can imagine that it's like a drug. Once you start winning, you want to keep going, you want to keep winning, I think that's important as a culture that we've set here to keep winning. And obviously, we're pissed off. We hate losing. And especially with this run we've been on, we want to keep it going, but start a new one.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.